So this is our video on security, because that's the number one question we receive from every single parent: is it safe? And what I can say with confidence is that the yearly meeting, the EFC, has taken every precaution necessary to ensure the safety of our most valuable assets, which are your kids, your students. And the first precaution that they take is checking. They have a checklist of things they do. First thing they do is they check our government's website about safety. And if they see an issue, then they immediately call the pastors down in Mexico. And part of this value of having several decade-long relationships with a huge amount of trust that we've built into these pastors, it's such a strong asset. When we go to Mexico, those guys are in charge, the Mexican pastors. And they know what's going on. They know how serious things actually are. If they give us a warning, the plan is to change the plan. But something that our youth director told me after 25 years of this relationship, 25 years of going down to the same churches, the same pastors, we've never once had an issue that was serious enough where the plans had to be changed because of security threats, an unsafe environment, terrorists, loose donkeys on the run. Never had a situation where we had to change the plan. The only thing that I can remember was probably 15 years ago when the border guards decided that they wanted to charge each van that came past a certain amount of money. And our leaders said, that's not gonna happen. And so we drove to the next town and crossed there just fine. And then when we came back, we came to the place where they wanted to charge us and there was no issue at all. So speaking of pastors again, I just wanna encourage you that we didn't just Google a random Mexican church and then email them and say, hey, can we come? This program has successfully operated for 25-ish years now, and the partnership that we've built with these specific pastors and churches benefits everyone. Our kids get to participate in a cross-culture experience, and the churches down south get a benefit from our encouragement and ministry as we work in their small towns. They know that we're coming, they are excited that we're coming, and they look forward to us coming.
All right, so as we talk about safety, let's talk a little bit about Eagle Pass. Eagle Pass is where we cross into Mexico, and it's been in the news a little bit lately. So some things to keep in mind with Eagle Pass. First, what's in the news right now is right now. The situation is going to look different in 6 months when we go, and we don't know what that situation is going to look like. Second thing to keep in mind is that the governor of Texas has said that everyone who's crossing illegally recently has left that border town within 48 hours. This is because they don't want to hang around causing trouble where they would get caught and sent back across the border. They want to get far away from the border. So who we are seeing in at Eagle Pass right now, we don't expect to be there. Third, everyone in our group is going to be together at all times. This is the rule for the border. This is the rule while we're in Mexico. No one goes off by themselves. And we're going to talk about this a lot more in orientation. But one of the things that we really do while we're in Mexico is we travel in groups. If one kid wants to cross the street to get a Pepsi from a vendor, we go as a group, minimum of 3 to 4 people. There's going to be an adult. There's going to be a male in the group. These are safe areas that we're going to be in Mexico, but safe doesn't give us permission to be naive. And so we want you to know that we are taking those precautions and keeping our kids together and keeping them safe.
So if you go and look at the State Department's website right now, the state of Mexico, where we're in, and again, they have states just like how we have states here in America. The state where we're going is Coahuila. And they have highlighted that saying, travel with increased caution. Out of a scale of 4, this is, I believe, a 2. It might be a scale of 5, but this is a 2. This is the second lowest warning that they give us. And increased caution is my attitude every time I take my kids to Walmart in Wichita. I'm aware of what's going on. And we don't want to downplay being aware in Mexico. But I also think that we shouldn't swing too far the other direction and be paralyzed with fear. If we're to be followers of God, then fear really doesn't have a strong place in our lives. And if it makes you feel any better, this summer, Mexico issued a do not travel increased warning to Washington, D.C. They were telling their Mexican citizens, stay away from Washington, D.C. It's too dangerous for you to go there. So I think that there's some leeway with the warnings people give us. We're not heading into a drug cartel controlled area. There is zero history in our mission organization of ever having any trouble. We trust the churches down there to keep us safe. We trust their judgment on telling us to go or to stay. And most importantly, we trust that God is going to be watching over the entire process. We've already been in prayer over the situation, and I'm confident God's going to protect us while we're down there.
As we cross the border, we've talked a little bit about safety and numbers already. This really comes into play while we do the border crossing. This mission trip, again, is not just Argonia and our kids here going to Mexico. We are with the Evangelical Friends Church Mid-America, and we're part of that group. And so when we get to the hotel in Eagle Pass on Saturday night, we're going to be meeting up with about 10 other churches. Several of them are going to have a lot more students than what we are bringing. And the really neat part about meeting up with these students is that if your kids have been in a junior high Bible quiz with us, they'll recognize a lot of these students. These are kids that they've seen and interacted with before. So we're traveling in one big familiar group as we go down there. Sunday morning, we'll travel to the border together as one big caravan. There'll probably be about 15 to 20 big passenger vans full of kids and adults. And this is one of the strengths of meeting with the other churches and going as one big group. Is that we are together. Safety is going to be on everyone's mind, and having that big group does work to our advantage. And so we'll travel as that big group across the border and then down through Mexico until we reach our individual site churches. And then we'll all be back together on Thursday for our big celebration. And then the same thing is going to happen on our return back to the U.S. We'll be one big caravan working together to travel and to get through the checkpoints and back into the U.S. And what's great about this is that no one gets stranded, no one gets singled out or left behind, and any issues that we have while we are crossing are going to be overseen and taken care of by the directors of the trip.